He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Okay, let's try some calculations regarding the density of a gas. A gas was found to have a density of 0.169 grams per liter at 17 degrees Celsius and a pressure of 760 torr. What is the gas? So we are going to need to do some calculations regarding ideal gases. So if you need to review that concept, go ahead and check out my tutorial on ideal gases first. And when you're ready, give this a try. Okay, so here's our given data, 0.169 grams per liter, 17 degrees Celsius, and 760 torr. So as we said, we're going to need to use the ideal gas law, that's PV equals NRT. And if we're going to identify this gas, we're probably going to want to find the molar mass of the gas. And molar mass is grams per mole. We have some information that is associated with mass. We have a density, so that helps. And then we don't have moles, so we are going to want to get moles. So let's solve for moles here. N is going to be equal to PV over RT. And so now let's plug in what we know. We have moles being equal to 1.00 atmospheres because we're going to have to convert from torr to atmospheres, and 760 torr is equal to one atmosphere. And now for volume, we have a density. Right, we have 0.169 grams per liter. So what if we just go ahead and assume 1 liter? Because we've got a ratio. So if we plug in 1 liter, and then we make sure to remember that that means that we're looking at 0.169 grams, then the math should work out fine. So let's assume 1 liter. Then we're going to divide by R, the gas constant. In this case, it's going to be the version that is 0.0821 liters atmospheres per mole Kelvin. And then after that, we have temperature, and that is 17 degrees Celsius, but we always want to express temperatures in Kelvin when we do calculations. So that will be 273 plus 17, which is 290 Kelvin. So if we do the arithmetic, we get 0.042 moles of gas. And now we actually can go further with this, because if we assumed 1 liter, we also assumed 0.169 grams. So we can go ahead and calculate the molar mass, because for the 1 liter sample that we are assuming, we've got 0.169 grams over 0.042 moles. And that gives us 4.0 grams per mole. So we know the molar mass of this unknown gas is 4.0 grams per mole. Now, luckily, this number is so small that it can only be one thing. This gas has to be helium, because helium is monoatomic, and helium weighs 4 atomic mass units. So there's only one gas that's lighter than that. That's hydrogen, and that's H2. That's 2 atomic mass units, or 2 grams per mole. So helium is the only thing that works here, and that is the identity of this gas.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.